Hi everyone. Today with NASA at Home, we are going to talk about ocean currents and create them for ourselves in a large tube like this. I'm Valerie and I'm here at the Chesapeake Bay, which connects to the Atlantic Ocean. I work on NASA's ICE, Cloud, and Land Elevation Satellite. ICESat-2 measures the height of the ice, the land, water, and even trees. Did you know that your tree height measurements from the Globe Observer app can help NASA scientists understand their data they're getting from space? ICESat-2 also measures the height of ocean waves. But did you know that the currents deep under the ocean are just as important as what is happening on the surface? The experiment we will do is called Motion in the Ocean and was developed under the Beautiful Earth program to show how ocean currents work and the importance of these currents in our global climate and weather system. You probably already know that oceans are salty, but did you know that large ocean currents like the Gulf Stream are powered by differences between fresh and salty water and cold and warm water? It's called the Global Thermohaline Circulation System. Denser or heavier liquids like salt water and cold water sink down. Lighter fluids like warm water and fresh water rise up to the surface. This creates movement in the ocean. And the driver, the major driver for this formation, is sea ice or frozen ocean in the Arctic. When sea ice forms, it releases salty water down, and this salty water moves down like you see in this animation. Not only is ice important for keeping the planet cool, it also keeps the ocean circulation system and our climate regulated. A parcel of water can take about 1,000 years to complete its journey around the globe. Here is the Chesapeake Bay. If you put trash out, it may eventually end up in the rivers and then into the bay, and then it may end up into the oceans and could eventually end up in the North or South Pole or on the other side of the world. So now let's test out how these ocean currents work on a smaller scale. We will need some simple materials to do our experiment. First, we'll need a tube of some kind. This is a tennis ball tube that I get out of tennis court trash cans, and it's a great way to recycle. If you don't have a tennis tube, you can use a graduated cylinder or be creative and take an old water or soda bottle and cut off the top to make a tube. Next, you'll need a tablespoon, some sort of stir, a pen or pencil, pair of scissors, some type of container to collect excess fluid, table salt, and food dye. I have two different colors here, blue and yellow, but you can use any two colors you like. You can even use clear and one color. And inner tubing material that you can find in the hardware store, or you could use the body of an old pen. Some play foam material, which you often find in dollar stores. We will be creating a separator plug to separate our salt water and our fresh water. And last but not least, of course, water. So now let's get to our experiment. First, what we need to do is we need to create our separator plug, and I'm going to move my tabletop surface over here. And what we need is our play foam material here and the top of our tube where we're going to trace out a circle using our pen and pencil.
So we'll trace that out here. And then we're going to trace out holes. So here's our circle. Next, we're going to trace out holes for our inner tubes. 1, 2. You want to center them so that they're about at the center and maybe a distance of about an inch apart here. Next, we'll cut out our circle. And if you can cut where you angle the scissors downward, you get a bevel on the edge of your separator plug, and that helps a lot to seal your tube. We're going to cut out our separator plug here. At a slight angle, cut on the line or just a little bit beyond the line. Okay. Next, we're going to bore out our center holes for our inner tubes, and I use a pen tip, it works great. And you just punch a hole through here and churn it until you create a hole in your separator plug. There's one. And here's the other. Okay. And then we will insert our inner tubes. And these, if you buy these in a hardware store, it doesn't cost a lot of money. You can just snip off how much you need with scissors. And you probably need about an inch, maybe 2 inches length. And then you insert your inner tube into the top side. And you want to make it flush with the bottom so that it does not protrude. So there, that one is inserted. We will get our other inner tube, which is right here. We'll insert our other inner tube on the bottom this time. There we go, and also flush with the surface, not protruding. So we have our top part and our bottom part. If you see, there's a little bit of a bevel. That helps to seal it. Next, we will take our two tubes, both half filled with water, and you want to try to keep the water at the same temperature.
Because as we learned earlier, warm water rises and cold water sinks. So you don't want to introduce too many variables into your experiment.
So next we're going to mix our salt water. And what we will need is our salt and our spoon here. So we're going to take about a big spoon of salt. We're going to put it into one of the tubes. This will be our salt water, and you mix it up till all the crystals are dissolved. Next, we're going to color our salt water. I like to use yellow, and I have 3 drops. 1, 2, 3. And we're going to mix that one up. Okay. So our salt water is colored yellow. This is our freshwater tube. And we'll make that one blue. 1, 2, 3. You don't want to put more than 3 drops of food dye in because otherwise it's too dark and you can't really see what's going on. So now we have our salt water here and our fresh water here. we are going to put the salt water on top of the fresh water and we're going to see what happens. So now we need to get our separator plug that we made. We're going to insert it into the fresh water tube. And you want to gently push down on all of the edges to insert the tube. And you just want to gently press so that you get your separator plug just on top of the surface of the water. And it's totally okay if you have air gaps in there. It works totally fine. So here we have our fresh water. And sometimes what happens is that you get some excess fluid and you have to pipette it off. So you can just either pour it off or pipette it off. Pour it into your excess container. Or you can just pipette it off. Okay, now for the next part, and this works great if you have a partner to help you. You need to put your finger on top of the inner tube here, and you're going to seal off that tube so that you don't introduce any salt water in there, because we have our separator plug separating the two parts. So what we're going to do is we are going to pour the salt water on top of the separator plug, and we're going to overfill our finger so that our finger gets wet. Now, don't do anything until we ask a question. Right now we have the salt water in the top chamber and the fresh water in the bottom. What do you think will happen when I take my finger off the tube? Well, let's see. Let's try it out. 3, 2, 1, go. You can hold it up to the light and see what happens. And try it out for yourselves. And if you save the top of the tennis ball tube, the cap, you can actually flip it over and do the experiment again without having to reload it. But you might want to do that outdoors so that you don't accidentally spill things all over the dining room table. So I hope you recreate the oceans in a tube and have a look at NASA satellites like ISAT-2 and Aquarius that measures sea salt salinity from space. And I hope you all have a wonderful day, and thank you so much for joining us.